So recording right now. Go.
Where's that story? Mr. Mountain stops waiting. The due date's coming. Life or death.
Where?
I can't stay in here for long. It's too dangerous.
I'm never gonna get the story in time.
I need to find the story.
I just don't know where it is.
I don't know where it... Wait. I hear people coming.
Yeah, I hear people coming.
Who is it? Oh, I just hit something.
I'm never gonna get this story in time. Where is it? Come on, I think I hear people coming. Who is it?
That story from Mr. Mountain's class in time.
Hey, what are you doing?
Jerry.
Hey,
Kilo Dad's punching him on time.
Come here, Mr. Mountain.
Story.
Saving the sun. In a tale of epic proportions. One man with the heart of a lion recounts a day of terror.
I'm Jerry. A daring tale of life and death.
A lot of fishing experience, I guess, of mine.
Off the coast of Alaska, in the Bering Sea, where a man can die of hypothermia in under 2 minutes from being exposed to the water, there's one man, one hero, and one story. In a place where between 24 and 35 people die each year by performing the same profession that Jerry's gonna go in to do.
Fishing a paleo crab up in the Bering Sea. About 80 miles to the northwest of St. Paul Island.
And just clarifying for our viewers, St. Paul Island is in Alaska.
Is in Alaska, yes. Up in the Bering Sea in Alaska. St. Paul Island is probably about, oh my golly, a couple hundred miles out in the Bering Sea.
The time period Jerry Kennedy is talking about right now is the fall of 1983. The water temperature on average 40 degrees. While these people look like they're playing it safe, they're not in the Bering Sea and they're facing far less risk than the kind Jerry Sr. and Jerry Jr. face at sea. Even these yahoos in Kabu cannot match the perils of crab fishing on the Bering Sea. Jerry Jr. may have believed the ocean was as good as the Little Mermaid made it out to be, until that fateful day. The day of truth and courage. Of will to survive. This fishing trip was one of Jerry Jr.'s firsts. He wanted to achieve the wealth, the power, and prestige that his father has gained from fishing over countless years. And just when things get to get calm at sea, tragedy strikes at the blink of an eye.
And all of a sudden, somebody yelled, "Man overboard."
This is the one phrase that you never, ever want to hear at sea. A man has gone over the boat and needs to be rescued. In 40 degree waters, he has 2 minutes. He's a slightly strong swimmer. Emotions are...
Oh my gosh. And this was...
I guess, and the boat rolled. And the pot slid off the side, or slid over to the edge of the boat.
On the vessel's deck, the railings are about 3 feet tall. The crab pots were stacked around 7 feet. He was on top of the 7-foot crab pots, and then the boat rolled, and the crab pot slid across the deck, hit the railing. He plunges into the icy, frigid waters off the coast of Alaska, the Bering Sea.
The person that went overboard was my son. That was my son. That was my son.
As soon as Jerry heard that, his reflexes, his adrenaline kicked into top gear. He whipped the boat around, got back to get him, threw him a buoy. The buoy was 10 feet short of the regulation 90 feet. It was unable to reach him. They whipped the boat back around again, they give him a buoy, and they rescued him.
The first thing is, when somebody goes over, if anybody sees it, is you point your finger, you point your arm and finger down at the person, and you stay there. You keep them in sight, and you don't do anything else. You just move so you can keep them in sight.
Jerry Jr.'s trip overboard wasn't pretty. Think about how north that is above the equator on the map that you're looking at. It's insane. You might even say impossible, but he did survive, thanks to Jerry's hard work, dedication, and life-saving skills.
An excellent swimmer, and that's probably the only thing that saved his hide, was he was a very, very good, strong swimmer.
Jerry's modest about who it was that really saved him.
I guess the first thought, the thing that popped into my mind is, what in the hell am I going to tell his mother?
Jerry Jr. was perfectly okay, a tad bit cold and shaken up, actually very cold, and Jerry did tell his wife 20 years later. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed. Have a good day, everyone.